Good morning and welcome to Exit Through the Gift Shop. Today we're at the Museum of Flight near Tacoma, Washington. Whether or not you're an aviation buff, there's a ton to see inside, so let's go and explore.
Just entering the main gallery. We're going to explore a bunch of these planes. Over here there's a section dedicated to early planes, right up here. This is a replica of the Boeing Model 1, which was Boeing's first plane, built in 1916. And here's a life-size reproduction of the Wright Brothers Wright Flyer, which was the first powered airplane, built in 1903. This Boeing Model 80 is an example of one of the earliest passenger planes, built in 1929. Prior to that, planes were used primarily for delivering the mail. This style of plane, the Curtiss Robin C-1, built in 1928, is best known for some of the records that it set. One such record was when it performed over 400 slow rolls in a row. On another occasion in 1935, this was piloted for over 650 hours straight. That's almost a continuous month in the air. This 1935 Lockheed Electra is the same style of plane that Amelia Earhart was flying when she disappeared. This is an actual piece of Amelia Earhart's plane, which was salvaged in 1937 when her landing gear collapsed in Hawaii on the second leg of her round-the-world flight. It's really interesting as you go along and read some of the stories behind these different planes and some of the facts about them and their histories. This 1955 Crusader is known as the last gunfighter, as it was one of the last military planes to include guns as its primary weapon. Future planes moved to having missiles and only had guns as a backup. I can't pass up the chance to sit in the pilot's seat of a Northrop Hornet cockpit or a Lockheed SR-71. Here's the inside. You can see the controls on the dash. Here's a J-58 engine built by Pratt & Whitney in 1958. It's known for being the world's fastest air-breathing engine and could travel at speeds of Mach 3.2. This is a Lockheed Blackbird M-21. This spy plane was built by Lockheed in the 1960s at the request of the CIA. The example on display in the museum first flew in 1964 and is the last remaining of its type. The M-21 acted as the mothership for an unmanned drone, which was mounted on top and then launched for further surveillance. This 1968 Taylor Aerocar 3 was built by Molt Taylor, who envisioned that there would be a plane in every suburban garage. Unfortunately, this is a prototype and it never made it into production. Pretty stylish, though. Some models of other potential Aerocar designs, including an Aero Jeep, this Aero Bus, and the Aerocar Model 4, circa 1987. Back behind them are the wind tunnel models that were used for the Model 1 and Model 3. This is a Bell Iroquois known as a Huey, which was used extensively during the Vietnam Wars. This device, known as a jungle penetrator, would be used for evacuations when it wasn't possible to land. It would be lowered in a collapsed form and then expanded by the evacuee so that they could be raised back up to the helicopter above. This iTech camera lens has a 30-inch focal length and was used for surveillance from over 80,000 feet above Southeast Asia. That is a very long camera lens. Outside and across the street is where they keep the big planes. We've got everything from 727s, 37s, 747s, the Concorde, and even Air Force One. Here's a full-size Boeing 747 Dreamliner, which was notable for being one of the first commercial airplanes to make use of composite materials. Let's go inside. Check out the engines powering these things. It's almost twice as tall as I am. And now we step inside the body of a 747 jumbo jet. See just how much space is inside one of these things. It seems to go on forever. Right back to the tail here. F-14 Tomcat. Here we've got a Harrier jump jet. This is known for being the first vertical takeoff and landing attack aircraft. And we're going to head inside a 727. This is the model of plane that was hijacked between Seattle and Portland by the infamous D.B. Cooper. It was in a space just like this that D.B. held hostages for ransom of $200,000 before parachuting and disappearing into the night over the forests of Oregon, never to be found. Don't look now, but I think behind me I might have found D.B. Cooper. And if you're wondering how FedEx ships your parcels worldwide, this is it. Stacked, back to back. And if you're wondering where your guitar went to, this is it. Inside the Museum of Flight. And look who's here. We can't leave without stepping aboard an actual Air Force One plane. Here's the cockpit. Those are the guys in charge of flying the president. Back here, lounge seating access. Oh, that's just the crew compartment. Here we go. This is a little bit more presidential. Get the presidential bathroom. The president's stateroom. In fact, this Air Force One plane was flown by the likes of Kennedy, Eisenhower, and even Richard Nixon. stepping inside British Airways, the Concorde. There you can see right down to the cockpit. Huh, they must have to keep the headroom down to make it fly so fast. The Concorde can reach 250 miles an hour at takeoff and can reach Mach 2 when it achieves 55,000 feet. This says that in 1973, one of the Concordes was used by scientists to chase a solar eclipse around the globe, from the Canary Islands to Chad. Right down to the end of the plane, very long and narrow.
That's it for today. Thanks for joining me to explore the Museum of Flight near Seattle, Washington. Remember to hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on other museums that we visit, and check out our interactive map to see all the cool places and attractions that we've already been to. Until next time, it's time to exit through the gift shop.